in the 1780s, and basically, you're supposed to sit in it, and the person would light a candle, and they would draw your profile on the paper, so you see that the face shows up.
We used to do this in kindergarten.
Yeah. So you've all seen cut-out silhouettes. So this was basically where it begins, the idea. But the idea behind it was to look at a person's profile and then to determine their moral character, if they were good people or bad people, right? And so this was part of the Enlightenment, I think, therefore I am. And so the idea was to measure and to know every aspect of the individual and to figure out what beauty was. Because if you were in Renaissance or sort of 18th century France, how did you determine what the future would be, right? Should we have kings? Should we have queens? Should we have private property? Should we have democracy? This is an idea that we're living right now, right? Whether that was precisely. So all of those ideas of the Enlightenment were tied up with ideas of what the individual are or would be. And those were the first time they had really thought about that. So this was sort of basically invented to draw with shadow. Instead of, cameras draw with light, right? They capture the light and create a negative. So just be thankful, because 40 years later they invent the camera, otherwise you'd be dragging one of these around to remember all your friends and loved ones. And so from that, I wanted to then go to Europe and see where this idea of, what did it look like when they started measuring and thinking what was beautiful and what was ugly, what was sort of the key elements of progress, the key ideas of what would be European culture. And so up here you see it's actually Frederick the Great's collection. Frederick the Great, if you're not familiar, basically was king of Prussia and helped to pay for the Enlightenment, right? So he hired Voltaire, and some say that Voltaire was a spy between France and Germany, and there were these letters. And so Voltaire also wrote that that Africans were animals, and so even the Enlightenment wasn't fully enlightened, right? And he writes a number of things around race that would be problematic to us now. And so, again, trying to think about how these legacies surround us right now. So if you turn on the TV, you'll find all this language about race and difference that dates back to these ideas and to these people. And unfortunately, we would think that some of this is ridiculous 200 years later, but we're still living it. So part of it for me was to try to create a project that would allow people to better understand the history of racial definition as we've inherited it and all of the ways that hurts us or helps us, depending on where we are in the discussion. So you can see here, part of the idea of when they were trying to figure out what progress would be, they looked back to antiquity. And so you see that the study of the profile, this is one from the Getty Museum, if you ever go there. And so you see the profile is nearly a straight line. And they used that to argue that that was a sign of moral, sort of moral progress. And you can see here now in 1850, that artists are being taught to do that, right? So they've taken this idea of the profile and they've now applied it to what they teach in class. And so you have all these artists going to a place called the École des Beaux-Arts, which if you've studied anything of the history of art, is where all the paintings came, Ang, Delacroix, and they all are being trained in this academic method, basically to think about how to represent otherness, to look at the antique, these are things from the Louvre, and then how to reproduce those ideas. We could also think of it as a way of constructing whiteness and reproducing whiteness as a part of arts education, basically. And that spreads out into many different aspects of society. So this is a copy, basically it's one of the sculptures that was in the storage facility, and then when they want to make copies of them, they mark all the different points, and then they measure using basically a sort of measuring device is used. So if my nose is this far from my eye, they would measure this, and then they would put that on the sculpture and measure to make sure it was the same. So it's a point system. It was the first way of trying to reproduce sculptures. And so basically taking that technology, which was a very modern technology, and then applying it to the construction of bodies. And here you see, of course, once we have this idea figured out, then we have the mass production of whiteness, basically, this idea of kind of an academic system that's going to produce more of the same. And so these are busts of Friedrich, who creates creates Watch for the Arts, actually, in Berlin. And then here at the end is Voltaire, This is a plaster copy of Voltaire that's in the École des Beaux-Arts in Paris. There's a copy also here at LACMA, if you ever go to LACMA in Los Angeles. You can see someone has carved a swastika on his head and also put some sort of lipstick or whatever and defaced it. And so when we think about the legacies of the Enlightenment, as that we've been taught in school, you can see at this particular school people are critiquing that, right? In some physical way, they're resisting what they've been taught and they're defacing or graffitiing the objects. And so there's other objects with graffiti, which we'll see later on. And that in a bit ties into the show downstairs, which is thinking about mark making, thinking about articulating ideas of difference through basically unauthorized expressions of speech, right? Whether that's written or graphic or whatever. So all of this idea of the Enlightenment is the backdrop for thinking about whiteness in Western culture. And unfortunately, most of our educators in classes and textbooks don't teach this. So if you've ever taken a drawing class, you've done that egg where you draw the circle of the egg and you put a line in the middle and make a little face. Mm-hmm. Well, that's basically the same idea of measurements and proportions. We actually all have very different proportions and distances of our eyes and mouths. And some of those have to do with race and ethnicity and genotypes. And so what we also have is the beginnings of constructions of otherness. So first they've sort of perfecting ideas of whiteness as they see it, and which makes sense. They're in Europe, they're trying to understand their culture, they're looking back to ancient Greece, they're theorizing notions of beauty, notions of democracy, notions of equality. They're arguing for private property, right, versus, all of these are argued for the very first time. They're part of the legacy we are unfortunately struggling through once again in our nation as we need to rethink each of those elements once more. And so basically all of those ideas of measuring then produce in that 18th century, which corresponds with the expansion of slavery and the slave trade through the Americas and through Africa, the exchange of mostly sugar and cotton, but also the exchange of bodies, the collection of bodies. And so what they would do is they would collect specimens from the world, you know, from the new countries that they explored, and then when they could, they made plaster casts of the heads to study. And we'll look at those on the other side. This is one where I basically put my own head in there as if it were a plaster cast to be studied. And this is a real machine. It exists in Paris, and this is a drawing diagram for how to make the machine, basically.